In this video, I'm going to go over the basics of adding SVGs to your website using JavaScript. If you haven't already watched our other videos about how to inline SVGs or how to use SVGs with image tags and symbols, feel free to check them out. To get started with loading SVGs with JavaScript, you need to create a JavaScript function that grabs the icons and displays them on the page. You also need to have HTML that the JavaScript function can refer back to. In this demo, I've created two elements with the class of icon that have their data icon attribute set to their path on my server. Next, I'll write a function that finds all the icons by using query selector all and looking for that class. Then, I can grab the URL from the data icon attribute and append it to my domain name. Now I can fetch that file and insert the text into the HTML of that element. Lastly, I can call that function to populate those SVGs on my website. The pros to using this technique are similar to inlining the SVG, because that's exactly what JavaScript does. To recap, you have full control over styling the element with CSS, and you also have full control with JavaScript. Another pro with this technique is browser caching, since the file is being downloaded instead of inlined. But this technique definitely has its cons, though. First, you need to create a framework around it for it to work. Any mistake in your framework may make you wonder why your SVGs aren't loading. Second, your SVGs won't be able to load until after the JavaScript is downloaded, parsed, and run. This has the potential to make your SVGs load into the page later than you'd like. Lastly, you can run into cross-origin resource sharing issues if the SVG you want to use is stored on a domain other than your own. I hope you've enjoyed this mini-series on four different ways to add SVGs to your website. I personally use SVG symbols the most, so I'll go over some helpful tips on how to use SVG symbols with CSS in the next video.